to another exciting edition of Cammy's Comic Corner, the Scott Pilgrim episode. I'm your host, as always, Cammy. Now, Scott Pilgrim is a book series by Oni Press, and it's created by Brian Lee O'Malley. It is by far one of my favorite comic books to talk about, but I never get the chance to because it's been slowly coming out these past couple of years. Well, finally, with the movie this weekend and the last book finally coming out, I finally have a chance to talk about it and explain to the masses, to all you fans, if you're not familiar with the title, why it is so awesomely amazing. So the main character is Scott Pilgrim. He's 23, lives in Toronto, Canada. He is part of a band called Sex Ba-Bomb with his friends Kim Pine and Steven Stills. The scandalous thing going on in his life right now is that he's going out with a 17-year-old named Nines Chow. He's got out of a bad relationship from a couple months back, and he just doesn't know what he wants right now, and so that's why he's dating this girl, Knives. She loves him, loves the band, and she's their number one fan because she's never been introduced to, like, live music before. Scott lives with his gay roommate, Wallace Wells, who pretty much owns everything in the one-bedroom, one-bed apartment that they live in. The only thing that Scott owns is his pile of laundry on the floor. Well, one night he dreams about this girl rollerblading through his dreams. And then sure enough, the next day at the library when he was with Knives, he sees her. And then he's obsessed with this girl, needs to know more about her. He finds out at this party of Steven Stills' on-again-off-again girlfriend, Julie Powers, that her name is Ramona Flowers. She had a big breakup in New York City with a guy named Gideon, and now Scott must have her. He must, you know, talk to her. So he tries talking to her, doesn't work, fails horribly, and so he finds out that she works for Amazon Canada. So he orders some things, some items, some CDs, and by the time she gets there, he won't sign for the package unless she hangs out with him. So they go out on a date. She finds out that he, you know, plays in the band, says, okay, sure, I'll come. And so while he invites her to the band, they're playing at the Rocket. They're right after Crash and the Boys, which is an amazing band. The first ex of Ramona's comes flying through the venue to fight Scott Pilgrim. What the fuck's going on, you might ask yourself. Well, in order for Scott to date Ramona Flowers, he has to fight and defeat her seven evil exes. And so Matthew Patel is number one, and he said, you know, didn't you get my emails? He didn't. So after they fight, he explodes into coins. He goes, oh, okay, so apparently this is on. I love this girl, so I'm gonna go ahead and fight for her. So there's six books out. There are this Precious Little Life, Scott Pilgrim versus the World, Scott Pilgrim and the Infinite Sadness, Scott Pilgrim Gets It Together, Scott Pilgrim vs. the Universe, and Scott Pilgrim's Finest Hour. And through the span of these six books, he fights at least one evil ex throughout. We have Matthew Patel, who's the first ex. We have Lucas Lee. We have Todd Ingram. We have Roxy Richter. We have Kyle and Ken, who are twins. And finally, we have Gideon Graves, who always seems to have some little hold over Ramona. And much like video games and comic books, you see one-ups, you see pixelated little woodland creatures. You have all these references that make if you've played one video game or have played thousands, there's something in this book for everybody. The humor is rampant. If your life had a face, I would punch it. I would punch your life in the face, and much, much more. I cannot get enough of this series. Recently, there was a movie that's coming out this weekend. It's called Scott Pilgrim vs. the World. And it is being directed by Edgar Wright, and it stars Michael Cera as Scott Pilgrim. I was fortunate enough to see it an advanced screening at Comic-Con, and let me tell you, I knew for a fact that this was going to be my favorite comic book movie of the year. Yes, better than Jonah Hex, Losers, Iron Man 2. And sure enough, it delivered. It delivered so nicely in this nice little package with a bow saying, for you, the fan. So while it's not going page per page from the transition from comic to screen, it's its own beast, and it's very, very faithful to the comics. I had a grand old time, and while I just gave you a glimpse of what this series is about, check out Geeky Talkie episode number 25. I had on Nick Fury, Haley Manbat, and Jeremy Awesome, and the four of us discussed in great depth and detail, so spoilers abound, the whole series, books 1 through 6, and our thoughts on the movie and the casting choices in the movie. And then we talk about the soundtrack and the video game as well, because both are pretty, pretty cool. Well, I haven't played the video game yet, but the soundtrack came out earlier this week, and it is phenomenal. So, go check out Geeky Talkie episode 25. You can find it on iTunes or at thecamuscomiccorner.com/geekytalkie. So that does it this special episode for Scott Pilgrim. I've been your host, Cammy. I'd like to thank my sponsors, Deadline Graphics at deadlinegraphics.net and Rising Sun Creations at rsc-online.com, where you can get Scott Pilgrim merchandise there. So until next time, next special comic book edition, this has been Cammy's Comic Corner. I've been your host, Cammy. Take it easy, and I happen to be the most awesome 23-year-old ever.